Well, it gave us something interesting to talk about. Commercialized content like that, sponsored content, there are many different ways to do it. There are all kinds of ways to take a product and encourage people to think about that product. One of those ways is sponsored quests in a role-playing game. So this weekend, I hope you'll tune in for Court of Swords, where the team will be taking on Oscar Mayer, the wiener god. He's been corrupted by bad press. And once you defeat the bad press, Oscar Mayer, the wiener god, will rise to glory and give unto you nutritious and delicious benefits. I've got a whole quest line built around relish. I think you're really going to like it. You know, it's... the thing is, I could do that. I could totally do that in, like, we could get a sponsored deal with roleplay, and God help me, I would not want to, but I'm totally capable of making a quest line in the middle of a game wherein the Oscar Mayer wiener is a thing. It's like a real thing. Like, it's not, this kind of content is easy. It's just kind of an atrocity. Fascinating though, isn't it? Like, don't you think? Like, strange and confusing and weird, but like, in a way, like a car crash, hard to look away. That's right, we'll show the world that bad press is a bunch of baloney. But you could do it, right? I think this is why media awareness is so, why it's so important, right? Because even though, like, no person will see or play this and think, wow, what a neat quest, and not immediately be like, I wonder how much Cup Noodle paid for this. I wonder... Like everyone can feel, and we know that it's like an insidious thing. But also, like I was saying before, it works. And being aware of its presence.
Is ebony really all that good?
Being aware of
its
presence.
I might have answered before, but
stop talking about
coffee.
Being aware of its presence in media is, and like why it works the way that it does, and what other things that games and TV shows and comics and shit make us think or want, how they affect our desires, I think it's super helpful and important, honestly. Like, I think it's really...
Ready for this?
Oh, hey, I need these whiskers. Come here.
Duly noted.
All right, regular swords and fire. Okay, I got the best weapon I could be using.
Good.
Maybe not in the best way. Yeah, armature that shit.
Watch the enemy's movements.
Ignis! Everyone form up!
Sure.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah. See ya. The whole stretch.
There we go. So that's a turn in for Sid.
Oh, glad that's over.
Yeah, me
too. Let's go back and play video games.
Go back where?
To our hotel room?
Not gonna happen.
Let's go back and play video games and eat Cup Noodle that we paid for with our American Express.
This one's no joke.
Focus.
Yeah, let's fuck up these long necks. Alright, swords, machinery, and lightning. Okay.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
You should know. Gotcha.
This doesn't look too good.
Gladio!
Sorry to break this up!
You ready?
What did we do magic-wise? Are you scanning this one, or am I just looking at nothing? Lightning. Okay.
Hello.
Definitely hit some of my friends. Look how crispy they are.
My pleasure.
Gladio, do it!
Sorry to break this up!
So here we are.
This can't be.
I got myself on that one. Oops.
Everyone regroup.
Right here.
Yep.
Can't keep on like.
I'm getting so much better at parrying now. Not like completely useless at it.
Don't die on me.
Here we go.
Here goes nothing.
Yeah. I even amaze myself sometimes.
I'm sure you do. Let's go turn in our quests. There we go. Now I'll get some money. Maybe I'll do a few more hunts just to bump up my cash. And then I'll go. Yeah. I'm trying to think of other games that have used product placement. Like, this feels like the most egregious example to me that I can ever, like, I've ever seen. But I think there are probably some games, like, I think the games that traditionally have product placement are games that, like, miss, that like, go by me because I don't, like, sports games, obviously. Because usually the sports franchise has some kind of product deal. Modern games obviously have it more readily available. There are games that are 100% product placement, right? Like the Burger King games or McKids or Cool Spot or that Avoid the Noid one that wasn't, it was a Domino's game here, but it wasn't.
Gotcha.
It wasn't when it was originally created. Those are all like big obvious ones. Ninja Turtles, the Nintendo game, had fairly considerable product placement in it for Pizza Hut. I believe you get a Pizza Hut coupon when you purchase the game, or did.
So, remember how I picked something up at the market the other day?
Uh-huh. Let's get ready to edgelord our way out of this situation.
Well, this is for you.
What is it?
You put your life on the line every day. So I wanted you to have a little insurance. A lucky charm.
It's hideous.
It's called a Moogle. This one's gonna look out for all you guys.
I hate it.
Keep him by your side, and he'll take care of you. And if he gets roughed up, I'll take care of him. I'll be in Kayam. Later.
I don't like this. No, I don't want it. In battle, the Moogle serves as a decoy. Okay, good. And then you beat it up, and I got 10 Moogle plushies. Great. That's Gladio's sister. It's Gladio's little sister. She has a crush on me. I was a dick to her.
The streets are boiling.
Too hot to move. Or do anything else.
No. Ah, cool game, kids. What's up, dude? I did your quest. Give me another one and then give me a bunch of money. What else you got?
Some refreshments. You'd help call pests?
I would.
You'll take on the job? Wonderful.
I wish I could just take a bunch of these.
Stay safe.
I could go do them. Gladio's still all hype because I gave him a cup noodle.
Whoa.
Well, I better buy some cup noodles.
Thank you.
They're
Take
so
care
delicious.
Clear skies with the temperature rising.
Nice.
Yikes. Folks think the reasons that they purchase things are, right? Like, if somebody asks you, like, they pick an object around you. Think about something that you, like, spent an okay amount of money on and you had to think about. Not, like, a random thing, like a hamburger or whatever. But, like, think about an object that you purchased recently. What helped you come to the decision about buying that thing, right? Maybe it's a camera, maybe it's a computer peripheral, maybe it's a video game. But what about it made you want to buy it? What decision influencers did you have on that thing? A lot of people will say, like, I bought it because I wanted it. Like, just purely internal. It's the only reason. Trying to take a photo, Pronto, or nothing? Okay.
Oh, hey! This is where that big bad bounty's supposed to live. Wait. You aren't thinking about hunting it.
Ideally.
Are you?
Ideally, the... Yeah, of course I am. Ideally, the reason we buy a thing is because it fits a need.
You bet I am.
It fits a Let's budget.
Go. Well,
and
if anything bad happens,
it's available
it's
to us, right?
It's not on anyone.
The things
we
like the purpose, the function.
I'll right? do my part, and you all do yours.
Yeah.
But
yes, you're right, big guy.
It isn't always the case entirely.
It should
and
be a nice change of
often
pace.
We forget that we're influenced in more subtle ways, right? That like, even if you are aware of things advertising and try to ignore it, it's still there, right? There are people putting money into you purchasing things. You know, a lot of people will say like, oh, I bought it because a neutral person reviewed it, right? Somebody reviewed it online and, you know, I trust their opinion. But there's no such thing as a neutral review, right? Every review ever is biased in some fashion or another. Advertising happens at all kinds of levels. And honestly, a recommendation from a person that you know or trust is really just like an unpaid ad.
Mouth closed.
It serves the same function. But we consider it to be less egregious, I guess, because
all in together now.
You know, they're not being paid. There's no compensation for their opinion. I don't know, it's interesting. I mean, I think we all want to be conscientious about where we spend our money, because it's, unless you're one of the hyper rich, it's in limited supply for you. I think it's an interesting thing to think about. I'm not trying to lead anybody anywhere with this. I just think thinking about it is, to me, really interesting. I find it valuable to think about and acknowledge the reasons why these things happen. Dead body.
Just being alive.
We'll figure out what those frogs are weak to, and then I'll craft some more magic, because I think I'm pretty fulled up on all three of the magic types. Fantastic. Fucking great. Get out of here. Shitty terrain. Oh, is this an only at night situation? Oh, come on. Why didn't it say something when I got the... Okay, let me look at this. No, daytime. Oh, daytime rainy. Oh, they only show up when it rains. That's irritating. I can't influence the weather, can I? Is there anything else around here? Yeah, I can go north. Pick up that quest. Oh, I guess I could go. Yeah, I could go back here and deal with this. Ah, that's so annoying. Okay. Well, let's just do something different then. Yeah, I guess we're right here. We might as well. Froggy Inaba. Froggy Inaba.
Everything in order.
Yep.
All right.
What's up, Belcher? Welcome to the squad. Thank you for your Prime sub. We were just discussing advertising. Because I'm at a high enough level that I can probably thrash whatever demons pop up. Prompto doesn't care about his own safety. Neither does Noctis. They're just flailing around in the car. Lovely and everything, but yeah, we don't want you to be a smear on the side of the road. Meldesio Hunter HQ. Cool.
Hey, Nut.
You want to see pictures of?
Oh, you just want
to go to the hotel.
Can we call it a night?
Hey, this
the hotel?
This means this means we're gonna get another Prompto cutscene. Cool.
No use trying to change your mind. Let's go.
Awesome! Nap time!
Indeed.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone get that hype about a nap. Prompto! You'll never make it to the hotel if you keep sitting
the
like that.
The sun's gone down. Now might be a good time to consider where we'll sit down for the night.
I'm with Iggy.
Spot here, there damn well better be. Yeah, here we go. I gotta try to remember to fuel
You ready to rumble, Noct?
Fuel the vehicle.
In King's Knight? Oh, yeah. I'm game.
In that case, I'll join you.
So the last time we did this, we got a prompto, like, bonus scene or whatever. So we'll see if we get another one.
This place really grew on me.
Oh, no, apparently not. Okay. Sure. Yeah, let's refuel the car. Huh? Pump my own gas? Weird. Anything else around here? Shops or whatever? No. Okay.
Ready for more?
You bet.
Let's hit it.
Oh, hey, wait, it's raining. We gotta go back. Okay, good, yes. All right, let's go fight those frogs now before it stops raining. Unless I fast travel there and it's not raining anymore. In which case, I'll be very annoyed. But that happens. Here we
might
go.
Want to stock up on potions and stuff.
Nice. You're being helpful for a change.
Shush, Prompto.
What do you mean for a change?
Shush. Tired of your banter. We have frogs to kill. To kill this frog, I need ice or spears. Let's make some blizzard magic. Oh, I already have some. All right then. Noctis, blizzard that fucking thing. Awkward noises they make when they're being hit with magic. It's almost as bad as the tase noises in that Deus Ex.
Potential for a fucking shoe. Any ideas?
up!
Nice work, Gladio!
Oh, good. There we go.
The last. Counter!
Hey! Sorry!
Okay.
Impressive.
Stop.
That took everything we had.
You should be proud of your drone.
I've got nothing left.
Stop. Stop with the music. I get it. I fucking get it. Jesus. Okay. Stop, game. There we go. Yikes. All right, I think we'll turn this in, and then maybe we'll go back and keep doing main quest stuff for the last little while.
Not much to look at.
At least we can buy weapons here.
Because that's what I wanted money for in the first place, was to go back to the future and then buy weapons. So let's go see what that is about.
Impressive work out there. Would you like something to eat?
No. I'm gonna go rest and I'm gonna summon my time traveling dog.
Acquiring a room?
Can I call Umbra? Umbra! Umbra, buddy, take me to the... back to the present. Yes, that's a good dog. Alright, let's buy some gear. Let's buy some gear. Time traveling dog, the greatest dog of them all. Yeah, they wake up, guys, I just had the strangest dream, and you were there, and you were there, and you were there, Cup Noodle. All right, let's do it. The whole purpose I went back in time.
I'll bet you don't know why they closed Costino off to the
public.
Hey,
Selden. How you doing?
I'll bet you don't either. hunters found something fierce down there.
Okay, let's see what this creepy guy has. What do you got?
Back for more.
I went into the past to get weapons and noodles. So let's see. Blood sword, thunderbolt. Oh god, it's all so expensive. Fuck. If I wanted to buy all of this, it's 5, 10, 15, 20. Fuck. Ugh, my god, everything's so expensive. All right, well, we'll just start buying this stuff. And let's sell some shit, I guess.
Come again.
I think I don't need the what is it called? Thunderbolt, because I think I have that already, don't I? Let's see. Bloodsword. Yeah, Gladio already has the Thunderbolt. Alright, I don't need to buy the Thunderbolt.
Welcome back.
So just the Wyvern Lance and the Delta Dagger. Oh no, the Delta Daggers I have. So just Wyvern Lance and Flame Gun. And maybe the shield if I wanted to. Let's sell some shit.
Again.
Now I will equip. Because I've had this fucking ice spear for about 1,000 years. So that's a nice upgrade. Oh, I forgot to go to Sid and upgrade that machine. Remember, because I got the coral whiskers? Oh well. And I haven't done Elemancy in a while. K2, welcome back K2, thanks for the re-up. Okay, Noctis, use a magic there. Okay, I guess we can just check here and then we'll go.
Welcome, boys. We don't have much, but you're welcome to browse at your leisure.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, you're welcome.
Take care, boys.
All right. All right, gents, into the pit.